Isaac Newton, Master of the Mint, by David Ashton.
I'm innocent. I swear it, sir.
The facts would seem to contradict you, Mr. Queston.
All lies.
Let us examine the evidence.
Piss upon it.
Let us examine. Mr. Haynes, can you bring the depositions?
Certainly, Mr. Newton.
Thank you. When my agents and I searched the cellars of your house, we found as follows. A cutter to render plate fit for coining.
What would that signify?
From my recently acquired empirical knowledge, it is the first step in the minting process. It produces coin blanks.
Means nothing.
Outside the house, in the earth, buried, hidden at the back of a broken chamber pot, was a stocking full of various dyes that would engrave both guineas and shillings.
Left there by some villain.
And in an outhouse, a large press to effect the coining of money.
That would be difficult to overlook, Mr. Quested.
I have sworn witnesses that your wife, Jane Quested, was observed to have milled the guineas from a mixture of genuine coin clippings augmented by pewter and other base metals.
What witnesses?
Friends and neighbours. What would we do without them?
I deny it all. I will stand trial.
You will be found guilty. And under the laws of this land, punishment will be the same as that of treason. For Mistress Quested in particular.
My wife burned to death.
That is the law. But sign a confessive deposition, and she may yet escape the flames.
And as for I?
It is a hanging matter.
My wife did just as I told her.
An exceptional woman.
I'll sign it.
Mr. Haynes, bring pen and ink.
At your behest, sir.
Can you read, Mr. Quested?
Of course I can.
A fine accomplishment. Top to bottom, please. Before signing.
I, Isaac Newton, have become a criminal investigator. How has this come to pass? Well, I'm not a stupid man, but neither am I omnipotent. And the events that have led me here were beyond my ken, and, even to a certain extent, behind my back.
Why are we always at war with the French?
National pastime.
Large armies must be paid.
You are Chancellor of the Exchequer, Mr. Montague. Moneys is your suit.
The Bank of England has tried. I have tried. Lotteries, bonds, taxes. We can raise no more from the populace.
Surely you do not contemplate vexing the rich.
I would be assassinated within the day, Mr. Vernon.
And as Secretary of State, I would be duty-bound to lead the firing squad.
The country has two crucial problems. One, a poor exchange rate of silver due to Dutch manipulation.
Silver is our standard, sir, like the British flag itself.
They both stand alone.
And the second problem, my dear sir?
The enemy within, counterfeiting. Scarce a coin in this country holds real value. Clipped, shaved, the silver mixed with inferior metal, then presented into commerce, it floods the country.
Surely the concern of the Royal Mint.
And Isaac Newton.
Your appointment. Should he fail, the Tories will tear you to ribbons. Mm. Does Newton comprehend the problem?
I have warned him of certain challenges. I am hopeful he will find a remedy.
A genius, to be sure. Gravity, laws of motion, the Principia. But that is natural philosophy. Politics, the real world, is a barrel full of rats.
Interesting, is it not, that everything, every living being, plant, creature, and most especially human, has time built inside its form. This rose, so beautiful, will wither and die. The butterfly that rests briefly upon the rose, so exquisite. The bee that sips so busily. All have their allotted span. Only God is eternal.
Now, my friend, how did you get past the cards, eh?
Therefore, apart from snails, we must live our time with joy. The Bible tells us so. I cannot say that Joyfulness and I walked hand in hand through the meadows of Cambridge, but I have caught glimpses in birdsong, a falling leaf, a plummeting apple as gravity takes its course, and further sightings within the exactness of mathematical thought.
Uncle Isaac, time for tea.
Time is indeed of the essence.
Mr. Montague trembles to begin the cakes.
It is your beauty, Miss Barton, that causes me to tremble.
It is the cake.
Appetite is everything.
I pronounce myself almost replete.
I'm grateful to hear so.
You had but one small slice, Uncle.
'Twas sufficient.
Sufficient unto the day be the evil thereof.
Spoken like a true politician.
Shame on you, Uncle, to tease so.
Charles Montague was my pupil at Cambridge, therefore I may tease him to distraction.
An average pupil, Catherine.
Yet behold you now, sir. Chancellor. The whirligig of time brings in its revenges.
Revenges?
A recent Tory broadside shouted on the streets to inform London, our greatest scientific mind reduced to that of a glorified clerk.
I would not term the Warden of the Royal Mint a glorified clerk.
Nevertheless, I am employed.
By the government?
The Whig government. Ergo, you are my employer.
Our honour and privilege.
Transported. Cambridge to Jermyn Street.
Plus a garden.
With snails and weeds.
My uncle has a somewhat punctilious attitude towards nature.
A decent virtue. And accordingly, I intend to begin official duties this very day.
I am sure you will more than meet the challenge, sir.
Gather me a fine crew, Jack. Skilled in the arts.
How many, Mr. Chandler?
4 will suffice. Sweet fellows. Quiet. Not talk out of turn. I want a house. Outskirts. No neighbours. Holborn. You can't sit in a looking glass here, save somebody at your back. Our craft draws attention. Find me otherwise.
Do my best.
Don't fail me, Jack Carter.
I've never failed you.
Good boy. Perfect time. A new fellow at the Royal Mint. Man of letters. Isaac Newton. We'll run him ragged.
Yourself, sir?
It would seem so.
Mr. Newton?
In person?
I've been awaiting you.
I knocked for a length of time.
The noise from the coining rooms can be considerable.
Ah, and you are?
Haynes. Hopton Haynes. At your service.
Now perhaps you might begin this service by allowing me entrance.
Oh, yes, of course. A little dark on these stairs. As well to guard your footing.
Are you a supervisor here, Mr. Haynes?
No. A clerk. Accounts.
Accounts?
The accounts of the Royal Mint are multitudinous.
Hard to breathe. Like a dungeon.
Almost there, sir. I climb these stairs every day.
I'm lost in admiration.
Here we are, sir. The clerks work in this space. Your office is through that small door to the side.
It is somewhat threadbare.
But never cold. In winter, the heat from the coining rooms below brings relief.
I'll be candid with you, Mr. Haynes. I expected to be met by Thomas Neal, the master here.
His presence is seldom noted.
Then who is in charge?
I am. I run the place top to bottom, and much thanks I get.
Mr. Elliot Miller, sir, our premier craftsman in silver.
You'll be Newton, the new warden.
I am.
We rarely see Mr. Neal. Never stops long.
Like yourself, sir. Finds it difficult to breathe.
So, he leaves immediate, for the sake of his health. Know anything about the workings of the Royal Mint?
No, but it is not my nature to remain in ignorance.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.